On this edition of Midnight Dread, a special tribute to reggae great and founding member of the Wailers, Peter Tosh, who was killed by gunmen at his home near Kingston, Jamaica last Friday night. For the next hour, the words, sounds, and power of the Bush Doctor, Peter Tosh, from his works with Bob Marley to his historic appearance at the One Love Peace Concert in 1978. We'll hear segments of an unusually frank interview I did with Peter the last time he was in San Francisco, but mostly we'll hear the Mystic Man's music. I'm Doug Wendt, and next, Peter's last single, just released last month and taken off his new No Nuclear War album, the record he had to sue his label to release, featuring drummer Santa Davis, who was one of the seven people shot by alleged robbers at Peter's home Friday. Santa was released from the hospital today with a bullet lodged in his shoulder. Two other people besides Peter were shot fatally. Everyone in the house was hit. All three gunmen escaped. The dead include Freed Eye, a Jamaican radio DJ of considerable import. Free Eye, who is due to air a major interview with Peter on Jamaican radio this Thursday. Peter's wife and manager, Marlene Tosh, is in good condition. Circumstances suggest that perhaps more than mere robbery was involved. Peter Tosh, word, sound, and power from No Nuclear War with In My Song.
The architect of the song, and me and Bob put the lyrics together.
Get up, stand up, stand up for your right. Get up, stand up, stand up for your right. Get up, stand up, don't give up the fight.
Don't give it up, don't give it up.
Get up, stand up,
get up, stand up,
stand up for.
But his music still, and you know, we talk to him softly because soft word turned away wrath. The grievous words stir it anger. Because music is a very high emotion. And to express that, you cannot be offended. But then again, the race is not for the swift. Neither is the battle for the strong. It's who can endure. This is the last year of me being treated that way, see? And it's only a pity that the few fans that I have out there won't be seeing me here in the Western Hemisphere no bomber-clad more, because I'm tired of being abused. Because I see where these companies, these big white companies, they are too hooked on rock and roll and get down shaky about where 3 years ago, I see where all the record company was talking about record, what they lost, their income loss in the record business. Millions of blood clot dollar, and that wasn't on reggae. Man, I'm tired of that. It's only that I can tell them. And one thing I can tell EMI and any company who went in my music, respect my music and respect reggae music, because remember, don't care how much them try to abuse reggae music, it's the only music that will live and leave all of these dead music, because they are trying to put life into the dead, and that can't work, because every time they try to generate life and drugs into the dead, it die again, rapidly, more rapidly. seeing, and that's what taking place because the songs that they promote, if them don't spend millions of dollars to keep them on the air, they die at birth. You know that? Yeah. And my potential and my integrity don't go for that because I don't even know cocaine.
Right.
And they're not going to like me because me don't take drugs and I don't want to know drugs, what drugs do, because I see what it does. I see how much great potential artists it turn into zombies and how much it kill. Seeing? And in 2 years you lose your progressiveness and your creativity. Seeing, you have to live on what people write. Me don't into that. We live in the garden of inspiration and I have to utilize that.
Crystal ball daily. I don't just talk